First off, man, you know, I cover Michigan, and I know you went up there recently for a visit.
Yep.
And, you know, looking back on that trip, what stood out?
No, I mean, it blew me away. I mean, getting around the players and seeing how they enjoyed everything, they're all definitely having a great time, and I think they're all benefiting from the academic and the football side. I mean, they have a huge alumni base, so I think they're all going to be taken care of while they're at Michigan, and even after that, I definitely got that feel.
Were you able to talk to any, which players in particular were you able to talk to?
For a lot of the day, I was walking around with Carlo Kemp,
okay,
one of their D tackles, and then I also got to see Chase Winovich.
Okay, he's interesting.
Yeah, I grew up watching Rashawn Gary. I mean, our teams played each other every year when I was a freshman, he was a senior.
Okay.
So I got to meet him, talk to him a little bit.
Okay.
And then I talked to pretty much the whole coaching okay. staff, Coach Harbaugh, Coach okay. Brown, Coach Madison.
Okay.
Kind of sat with them a little bit.
Okay, so
let's
talk about Rashawn. Obviously, he's a guy that you said you got to play against. And that's got to be pretty cool for you, knowing that he was the number one player in the country coming out of this area. I mean, what was sort of his message to you?
Oh, no, he just told me to keep grinding because you can see from him, I mean, He bought in there and it's gonna pay off. He's probably gonna be a first round draft pick next year, and he's gotten everything he wanted from that.
And then Harbaugh obviously, and did you meet and you met Don Brown? What was sort of Don Brown's an interesting character, and Michigan's defense has been top five since he's been there. Yeah. I mean, what was sort of his vision, his message to you?
No, Don Brown's a high energy guy. He had a great plan for me. He said he wants me to play there. The weak side DN.
Okay.
And you said that you see me attacking from a bunch of different places.
Okay.
And doing a lot for their D line.
Where's Michigan sort of stand right now in your recruitment? You said, I mean, you had a great time, and I mean, obviously all the schools are coming after you.
Of all the schools I visited, that's been my favorite so far.
Okay.
I'm visiting a few others this next month, so I'll have a better idea of where they stand.
Well, what schools have you visited so we can compare?
Wisconsin, Northwestern, Boston College. All the Ivy Leagues.
Okay.
Went to Notre Dame last year.
Okay, and Michigan stands up.
Michigan stood out.
What schools you got lined up coming up?
Stanford in a little over a month.
Okay.
May 12th. And I'll probably take either an unofficial or official to Clemson and Notre Dame. And I'll probably wrap things up after that.
Is that sort of those are the last of your visits? Do you want to make a commitment here earlier than later?
I'd like to make one kind of going into my senior season, so going into it, I can just kind of focus on that. And
could you see yourself going back to Michigan for another visit?
I meant to say, yeah, I'm definitely visiting there again.
So you think you might take an official?
Probably, I may take advantage of the new spring official rule.
Okay.
And go
so
there again.
Do you know for sure which schools you would take an official? It sounds like Stanford.
I don't know if Stanford's doing that this year, but I'm definitely taking an unofficial in a few weeks. But probably Clemson, Notre Dame, Michigan.
Okay. Official. Is that your unofficial top four? I mean, do you have a top four or anything like that? I mean, you got to start winding down that list.
Yeah, that's in the works. I'd say them and Northwestern are my top five.
Okay, so we'll just say what? Michigan, Clemson, Notre Dame.
Stanford, Northwestern.
Is your top five?
Unofficially.
Well, we're not going to say in any particular order, but we'll just say that's your top five.
Yep.
Fair enough. And then you're looking to commit here before you start your senior season.
I say in between June and July.
Between June and July?
Yeah.
So what are going to be the deciding factors when you're breaking down a school? Obviously, it sounds like education's high on that.
Yeah. I mean, the thing is, all these schools have great academic reputations, so they're all pretty similar. So I'm going to have to dig a little deeper to see what I like about it. What's really important to me is to see how the other players are enjoying their experience. I want to see if they're happy, if they've loved their time there, and I think that's going to be a big thing for me. And I think also how my family feels about it, and how safe they feel sending me. I'm going to be gone for four or five years, so I have to see their input on it.